Ladies and gentlemen, hold on to your seats. We have with us Miss Krishika Lulla, the glamorous, illustrious Indian film producer. Gentlemen, put your hands together for the ever charming and ever lovely Miss Lulla.
Well, yesterday we had a session with an actor from the Hindi film industry, lovingly called as Bollywood with some like and some don't. Doesn't matter, it's here to stay. Krishika, you are a woman film producer. Your family's been into the business for a very long time. You are Eros International, the largest producer of films in India. How does it feel to be a woman at the helm of the largest production company in India?
A very good evening to everyone present here. I feel with willpower and determination, you can succeed anywhere, whatever you want to. I always followed my dreams and my courage, being fearless, all this did, I realized when I had to face, and I'm here because of that. And I would say I would give all my credit to my team, whoever is working with Eros International, who has been like thick and thin with me and supported me all the way.
I was thinking maybe we should switch mics. My match is with red and your match is with green. Would you like that? Okay.
Why not?
Thank you. So, we already talk about the Indian film industry as the largest, right? And yet, you're expanding. You're foraying into regional cinema. India has a wealth of regional languages. And you are getting into a space to have a vibrant regional cinema in each of the states of India or in each of the linguistic regions of India. This seems to be a great appetite for entertainment, for the cinematic experience. Would you like to share a little about that?
Yes, of course. Because Eros is always known for making Bollywood movies. So we thought of venturing into regional cinemas. So we did two Marathi films. We backed two Marathi films called Funthru, which was a sci-fi romantic love story. It's very different and never ever touched, even in Bollywood, such kind of subject. And we did Anzara Hatke, which is also a beautiful story which touches a human relationship. So it was a good experience to try to venture into Marathi cinema too. Following up with maybe Kannada, Bengali, we are just releasing called Posto. So it's a good experience because each religion at each little country gives you a different feel which makes you more aware of what is going on in, you know, all each state.
Well, we're all very curious and we would like to know, being, heading such a busy production house, such a large production house, what is your typical day?
My typical day? Just for me is, I would be saying that my typical day, the day I hear a good script, gives me a lot of high, and as we all are women, we face a lot of multifarious work. So the chores we got to do, I like the way I manage myself. Sometimes it's difficult, but sometimes I enjoy it too.
You know, I was listening to one of the interviews of Nicole Kidman. She had come to India. And somebody asked a question about Hollywood versus Bollywood. And asked her that, when do you think Bollywood will become like Hollywood? And I think he meant it in terms of technique and style and quality. I don't know. But he just said, when will Hollywood become what? When will Bollywood become like Hollywood? And she said a very beautiful thing. She said, would you want to? And I thought that was so beautiful, saying that Hindi film cinema has its own identity. Our songs, our dances, our unique way of entertaining people. It's so unique to our culture. And is there something you see that there's now a convergence? There are a lot of international studios that are coming into India, making Indian content, Indian movies, but a lot of people from abroad coming here as well, bringing their own technology, writing. We were talking about Raj Nayak from Colors was here the other day. He was talking about a dearth of writers, new writing. So do you think as people from abroad, foreign studios come into it, they bring their own technique, they bring their own vision, is there going to be some change that we see as an influence from Hollywood into what we know as Bollywood? Or do you think that Hindi film cinema is already going through its own evolution, its own changes? We now have small budget movies, for instance. We have a movie like Pink, for instance, which is openly talking about when a woman says no, you stop. I mean, things like that. There's organically an evolution in Hindi cinema. So where do you see this going? Do you see us influencing Hollywood, or Hollywood influencing us, or a mix of both?
I would truly say Hollywood is influenced by Bollywood. I say because, one small example, we are doing very well. Bahubali is going to do more than 1,000 crores. So that shows it all, that we are there. Of course, there are a lot of subjects. If you see Japanese film, if you see different Korean film, they all have Bollywood touch. The emotions, because emotions are the same, whether it's Hollywood or Bollywood. I think there's no comparison. They think differently, and if we think that kind of way, I don't think so Bollywood would accept such kind of films. I mean, the Indian audience, I meant. So I feel we have our own stake and where we are, and we show the innocent, we show emotions, we show the grounded version, what we all are from beneath. So my take is, obviously, Hollywood is following Bollywood.
Do you think the film industry is a male-dominated or a male-determined industry? Or you think women are coming and playing their parts, such as yourself? You're very much part of decision-making. So do you think that's a rarity, or do you think that's more and more women are taking interest and stepping into decision-making roles?
Of course, it's a man's world, I would say, still. But in few places, of course, their leadership is still existing. And if you go to see, we have all technicians, to our directors, to producers, which I don't think so. Earlier, they thought that a woman would face the intricacies of film production where I am today. It was a difficult task. I would say nothing come free in life. So you have to work. We all have to face the obstacles with a pinch of salt. So why not in this field? I think earlier I thought that, you know, a woman has a little limit. But even if you go to see in like Dangal, they showed that how women, you know, whether it's strength or whether it's by Zoya Akhtar did a very good, she was a very good director, her field. So there are different fields, we all are coming, and it's just that our vision is very different, and we can mix between what a man can handle only one thing. A woman can handle multifarious things, they can handle the, we deal with different kind of people each day. So that's how, like, you know, versions of employees or, you know, talking to people. So even that matters. So we know how to balance ourselves and work through it.
There's a recent trend, a phenomenon of stars, especially women actresses from India, who are moving into the West, into Hollywood, so to say. There is Priyanka Chopra, who's got Quantico in the US, and it's, you know, doing very well. There's Deepika Padukone, who's moving into Hollywood. So, and there is a sort of, you know, demand as well from the West of Indian actors, Indian actresses, to come and star in, with a, be it Baywatch for Priyanka Chopra or, you know, other things. What do you think is driving this? You know, why is this sudden surge? It's not that we didn't have talent before.
No, I would say we have talent. That's the reason that Hollywood has searched and culled the right people. They know that, you see, Irfan Khan, there are many other people they are trying to cull from Bollywood, because they've seen the talent in them. And we are very proud. They made us proud. Whether it's Priyanka, whether it's Deepika, they made us all proud that Hollywood people are recognizing our talent much more. And they would love to see an Indian actor to be in one of, in, be a part of their film. So I think it's, we are not asking them to come with it. We seldom see any Hollywood actors in Bollywood cinema because they don't really fit into it unless it's just a cameo or something. And I'm very happy that Hollywood has culled the best actors, Priyanka, Deepika, Irfan, there are many other, Ali Fazal has done. So many more they are... They have been inviting many more actors to come and join them.
Do you think Indian directors will end up going that way too? We've got Shekhar Kapoor who did that with Elizabeth. Do you think this trend is going to, first the actors of course, it's going to start up, and then do you think some of our good directors are going to also be in that sort of a space?
There are some directors who have ventured first there and then they have come here. Like my Marathi director, he's a National Award winner. He started his career in LA, and now he's doing his now he's doing Marathi films. So, vice versa, direction is creativity. Creativity can go to any extent, whether it's Hollywood or Bollywood. It's just that it has to work. The content has to work, and they should understand the culture. What kind of culture these Hollywood is looking for, or Bollywood is looking for. So it depends, and that's how I think they'll be successful.
India, you know, Indian diaspora is everywhere, and they all wait for the next Indian movie coming out. It's a big connection, an emotional connection with back home, right? So how much of the Indian diaspora, let's say, expectation of the box office collection or content, what kind they would like, or locations, what they would like to see, given their sensibilities that they live abroad. How much of the diaspora thinking, how much do you think of the Indian diaspora in terms of finances, the economics part of it, in terms of content, you know, what they would like, when you get into deciding what should go into the making of a movie? Is it an important element that you consider?
Of course, it's the most important element. First is the content. I feel my hero is always the content, not the actors first. Now, if my content is good, the actors will follow, and especially, and then the director. First the content, second is my director, who can understand the vision of the content and believe in the vision of the content. So I would say after that is budget. Even budget is very important. You can't spend more than what is required, because if you do that just to show the flamboyant and the, you know, scenic kind of picturesque, when it's needed, we need to show, or not just forcefully add the budget to it. Because at the end, we are looking at the box office collection. All the hard work shows, but it has to be appreciated with the box office connected. So think wisely. The content tells you everything, whether you would like to see the film. Even the trailer can tell you, because then that's how we will, you know, everybody looks into it. If whether it's Hollywood, you would just see the, we don't know the actors in Hollywood. We know only the actors in Bollywood, and they're more recognized. So when you see a Hollywood film, you see the trailer and you decide you want to go. So we are heading there, and to say that the content works perfectly, if, you know, we would like to watch it or we do not like to watch it.
Krishika, what would be your message to women, women entrepreneurs, women leaders, women in business, and a lot of women in the media, in the film world, elsewhere as well, who would look up to you and want to do something? What would your message to them be?
For me, it started with a thought which has culminated into a beautiful dream for me. Earlier, I was a very shy and a very introvert, struggling woman, I would see in my yesterday's years. And today, I see myself that I have overcome my fear. I've been very persistent. I've been very patient, which is very, very important in this field, because you lose your patience so many times. And that's where you stop going ahead. Don't you think I wouldn't have heard a no from an actor or a director? Since, even though I'm coming from a film background, it was maybe my company, but I had to earn my way, my path. I've heard a no from an actor. I've heard a no from a director, but doesn't mean that I stopped dreaming. I went ahead. I still went ahead, and I'm here. I'm very successful right now. I'm being very proud to say that, because people recognize me and I enjoy that, because it has been a struggle. Everybody has to go through that and enjoy the struggle. I feel I'm still struggling. The day my struggle ends, I feel I've not achieved. My achievements will be stopped. So I think let the struggle go on, and I need to do a lot more than I am today. Thank you so much.
How do you, as a production house, because not every film is a box office hit, it's a very uncertain terrain. There's no formula. You don't know what works. A star may work, a star may not work. A good story may work, it may not work. You just never know what clicks. A high budget may work or a low budget may work. You just don't know. How do you process the losses that you as a production company go through? The misses, the hits, of course, maybe they make up for the losses, I don't know. So how do you process the losses or films that don't do well at the box office financially?
It's a process, as you said. It's like a circle. Some movies work, some movies don't work. Exactly, we don't know the formula at all. If one would know the formula, I think we would just have hits and hits. So we don't know, you know, I feel it's just a mood. People would love to see, sometimes they're in a mood to see something very drama and love story. And sometimes they would like to see any kind of cinema. So I feel mood swings, nobody can come to know of a person. Nor of the vision of the people they would like to see, the audience would want to see at that time. So sometimes if a love story is working, I think 10 love stories come off. So it's like a cycle. So it's just like we need to believe in the content, what we are doing. Just go with it. And I feel if you know, if you can connect with the audience a little bit, I feel somewhere you're going on the right path. Whatever films I've done in my past, I've always tried to connect with the people. Maybe it's NH10, like, you know, for me that thought started, like, we read in the newspapers so many tragedy which goes on. And when we read for a minute, we feel so sad, sorry about it. And then we turn our page and then we see some nice entertainment, we laugh it out. We've forgotten what we just saw a minute back. It's just gone. So thought of making NH10, which is actually happening in parts of Delhi. I think we all know about it. So seeing the vision, and when I came out of the cinema, a lot of people I met, they had so many stories to tell me, saying that, okay, this did happen the other day with us, and it happened with the following person or the other. So it connected to people so well, and they had that vision with them. It stayed a longer time than reading in the newspaper. So it's the way you connect to people. If you connect to the audience a little bit, I think that's the way we need to hit and direct our vision.
Do you spend yourself some time on social media?
We all like to do. I like to do at my ease, and why not? As a woman,
I'll rephrase my question. As you know, being in the production, you just mentioned about keeping a pulse on the audience, because it's very interesting what you said about that it all depends on sometimes the mood of people, which is very new. I haven't heard this before. It's a very interesting insight that it's actually, you know, a film may or may not work because, you know, of the mood of the people.
They would, of course. I might give you an example. Today you're sitting at home and you're feeling like, okay, lethargic, and you don't feel like going out and don't want to party. So you go through the cinema, you see the trailers of the cinema, of the film. And here you have a comedy, here you have a nice horror film, here you have, like, you have variety for you. So what would you pick? Depends on your mood. Exactly. So that's what I was trying to say. It depends on the mood, what people want to see at that time. Sometimes you really want to see something, but I feel mostly the entertainment kind of film does work. Very serious kind of cinema is very less, according to me, because we all have problems at home. We would love to go and laugh and come sometimes, and I feel always, not sometimes. So it depends on the mood. Am I right?
Absolutely. So what I meant was that like you said, if we could find a way to stay connected, you know, to the people, what they are looking for, what is the sentiment. And today social media, and Eros has ventured a lot into Eros Now as well. There's a digital presence that you are having. The world is becoming digital, so that is an additional screen one has to take into account. So do you use this connection with social media, do you think it helps to sort of figure out, keep an ear on the ground and say, what's happening? Does it sort of help into your decision making and keeping a connection with the mood of the people, or, you know, what's happening?
As you said, this is a very difficult formula. You cannot know the pulse of the audience yet. We don't know the formula. It's just that we need to go with our guts and the content. Let's change the mood of the people. Let's give them this entertainment. Let's give them different kind of vision. Let's give them something which they have not seen, or something what they know and it's they have gone through in their earlier yesteryears, or they would love to see the love story. Okay, have we met that? Some connection. So just enjoy doing that, you know, very grounded kind. And somewhere in our dreams we have that, okay, you know, everybody, especially in love story, we all want our lover boy to be very, like, always want to love you the way you had the vision. Maybe you don't get the same. So at least you like to see in your dreams, and dreams are entertainment for you.
As it's a family business, you know, there are other members of the family who would be taking care of certain aspects of the business. And are there certain aspects that women would contribute more to? I don't know, maybe the creative aspects or content, or is it stereotyped around gender? You know, certain aspects that you would take care because you're a woman, and certain aspects that men would take care in the family because they're men, or you cross lines and, you know, you take care of each other's areas as well. How does it work?
It's nothing like that. It's the way, if I always wanted my husband to take care of the financial part, keep budget, just give me, I take the story to him. I said, this is what the budget is. So he gives me a round figure, okay, this is the budget, you want to work on this, you can do it, not exceeding. So I would give him the part to do that. And there's no such thing, there's gender difference and discrimination, because my CEO is a woman. My PR marketing head is a woman. The PR head, the marketing head, and we have so many of the young talent with us. So I enjoy working with them. It's we exchange a lot together.
All I can say is I'm very proud that the largest film production company in India has its helm in the production, in the family business part of it, a woman, and it's running marketing part of it, as your CEO, like you said, also a woman, and so many other women. With that, I think we'll come to the close of a one-to-one with Krishika Lulla. And since she's here, if the audience would have any question here to ask her, I'm sure Krishika would love to take that. Alka, would you have a question?
Thank you so much for being here. I'm staying in Washington, D.C., and when Harbeen said, you actually took my question and comment right out of my mouth. We're so honored to have our girls like Priyanka and Deepika come over, and they are doing such a fantastic job. Do you feel, and please be honest, right, do you feel that the women, the female actresses that we have in the States, can you see them translating just as seamlessly into Indian films?
It all depends on the content, because they need to speak our language very fluently. So if they can manage, maybe the Indian audience will accept them. But if they need a foreigner, there are many foreign actors, but they come in the role, it all depends on the content. If the content demands a foreigner, non-Indian speaking woman, so there would be a space for them. Otherwise, it's difficult.
Right. And that's what I was feeling, that the translation might not happen as well, but where I was coming from is that the style in which I feel our Indian actresses are able to deliver, and, you know, I mean, I reside over there, but the way we are able to translate beyond language, it is just, it's something brilliant to watch. So I was just curious from your point of view. Thank you.
Thank you.
Is there any other question? Okay, with that, we come to the close of a wonderful session with Krishika Lulla from Eros International. And we are most delighted to have her here speak on the media from her heart. It's very refreshing, Krishika. Thank you so much for being here. And we would love to honor you from the Women Economic Forum. Would you like to say a few closing words?
Now, I just say thank you, all of you, to be here and to listen to me.
Thank you so much. I now request Mansi. It's our absolute delight to present the All Ladies League and Women Economic Forum 2017 Award of Women of the Decade in Family Business and Entrepreneurship. Do Krishika.